This is Gemara and Chagiga Daf Yud Ches. All learning for today has been generously sponsored as a schos for Shlema for Yehudas Basleya Shlamis, Miriam Gabriela Basluma Yisrael Yizik Bendina, and Mirz Hashem. They should have a complete recovery. The surgery should go well at the right time. As well as the learning should be an incredible schos for Shlema Shal Yiz Ben Ravida Ben Raviga Chaim Sarge Shlam Zimun Yiz the service. Can I eat the Basim Shal Yisrael Yisrael Ben Delez of Earth Shalay 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 Sir, about killing him, Zachman has you this for the Roman Rukhlada, Shim Ben Khan, I've got her about Esther. Besides our Khali Israel, finally the learning she has Khashil, so Khaim Dorish, remember, as he's a good to send this for Shanamak, Markham, some Shin, those good of some Shin, the Shim and Khaya. Of the Gwen Tali Shaman Levi Zahav, the Shwan the Shidduch, Bekari Mamish. We're holding on the very top of Yur Chesam and Aleph in the final. Home stretch, a little more than a week left. Incredible to not only Mesechtas Chagiga, to the entirety of Seder Mayim, Emir Tashem, the next day or so, a proper time and date for the Siyam will be Emir Tashem sent out, hopefully already. Tomorrow or somewhat, we'll be sending out an email. Anyone who has not responded, feel free to either respond via the email or the WhatsApp, and all the details will be disseminated. So we're picking up in the very top of Yurchez Amir Aleph, very Shlokish Amar. We're in the middle of discussing the halacha of Tashlumim, most poignantly, most particularly on Shavuos. Then not only, even though Shavuos itself is one day, but you have 7 days to bring you the Karbanos. It says, the Gemara says, Reish Lakish, V'chag Katsir, says the Torah, V'chagar Katsir, Asher Tizra Basad, Bikurim Ma'isecha, excuse me. So the Gemara explains, Ezu Chag Shatachoygig V'Katsir, where do you have a Yontif, that's a Yontif and V'Katsir, and as well you harvest by, Havi Omer Zatzaras, this is referring to Atzaras, and therefore, Havi Omer Zatzaras, correct. Continues the Gemara, Amas. Now, when exactly are you going to do both? You're going to be Chag and you're going to be Kaitzer. You're going to bring the carbon Chagiga and you're going to be able to be doing the harvesting. Says the Gemara, Amas. Ilema biyantiv, Ksira biyantiv, Yishari. Of course, you can't do the actual Ksira. You can't harvest crap on Yantiv. Alalav, Litashlumim. So says Reish Lakis, this is a source that there is a din of Tashlumim. Amar Rav Yechanan, says Rav Yechanan, Lameata. If based on your drasha. What was the drasha? Chag HaKotzir, Choygeg, Chagigo with Kotzir Ksira, teaching us that at the time of the Chagigo, you're able to do Katsira. So therefore, it can't be Yontiv itself. Therefore, there's a period of Tashlumim. That's Rabbi Yechalal Me'at, based on the same formula. Chag HaSif. It says regarding to Pesach, the Yontiv of Gathering, Ezu Chag Shishba Asifa. What is, let's learn the exact same formula, says Rabbi Yechalal. What is the Yontiv that there is Asifa Gathering of Yom Rizeh Chag HaSukkis. And why is that Pesach? This is Chag HaSukkis. And again, what's referring to Amos? Elema B'yantif. It's referring to Yantif itself. Malacha B'yantif Mishari? Of course not. You can't do the Malacha B'yantif. Elo B'chol HaShamayit. So Mas referring to Chol HaShamayit. Like you just learned by Shavuos, it's referring to the period of Tashlumim. So to your B'yantif, it's referring to the period of Tashlumim. But I asked the Gemara, Chol HaShamayit Mishari? But is that accurate? We learned the entirety of Mesechus Ma'ikayin, in which we learned that Malacha Nechala Ma'id is not as simple as many of us probably have always thought, but rather Chala Ma'id Mishari. You're not allowed to do work on Chol HaMoed. Elo, so rather, what do we have to learn? Chag HaBo Bizman Asifa. That when the Torah says a Chag HaAsif, it doesn't mean like you, Reish Lakish, thought. It doesn't mean to teach me that there's a chag, there's a chagig at the same time as the asifa, there's a chag, a chagig at the same time as the ksira. No, it just means a chag bizman at the time of the asifa, achanami chag ba bizman, ksira. It's the yontif at the time of the ksira, and therefore there is no raya, says Rav Yechanan from your pasuk Reish Lakish to chag ha-ksira. Chag HaKotzir, there is no raya teaching me that there's a din of Tashlumim. Says the Gemara, okay, you just mentioned that doing Malachar Chol HaMoed is Asr. Let's go a bit deeper. Mechlal, the Tarvayu, Svirlu, the Chol HaShamayit, that's Asr. So it sounds like, from basically the previous equation, Rav Yechram Reish Lakish, everyone is in agreement that work on Chol HaMoed is forbidden. Chol HaShamayit, Asr, Ba'asiyas, Malacha. Menani Mili, where do we know this from? The Tanur Rabbanim learned learned in a braisa is chag hamatzis tishmar shivas yamim. The yom tov of Pesach you should guard for 7 days. Li meid al chayil shalmai. This teaches me shasvas yis malacha. You're guarding the yom tov. You're not doing malacha for how long? It doesn't say 1 day. It says 7 days. That teaches me that there's an iser, there's a forbiddance to do malacha for all 7 days. Divrei Rav Yeshaya, including chol hamoed. Rav Yonasan amar inoy tzarich. We don't need a pasuk itself. Why not? Kal v'chaymer. We can learn from a kal v'chaymer. Omer rishon v'shvish in kedusha lefneim l'achreim aser basiz melacha. On the first day of Yontif, on the seventh day of Yontif, where there's no kedusha pre and post. The first day of Yontif, the day before, is mundane. The last day of Yontif, the day afterwards, is nothing. It's aser basiz melacha, and yet on those days there's a forbiddance to do work. So it says Rav Yonasan cholo shalmayid in the interim, in the middle days, shish kedusha lefneim l'achreim, that there is, they are bookmarked by kedusha. Therefore, tekel v'chaymer, says Rav Yonasan, you do not need a pasuk. Says the Gemara, not so fast. Rav Yonasan, you think you have a kel v'chaymer, but 1 second, look at every day of the week. Sheishes yamei bereishes, the 6 days of the week, yichichu, will prove that you, Rav Yonasan, are incorrect. Why? Sheish kedusha lefneim l'achreim. Every day of the week has kedusha bria and post, bookmarked with a Shabbos before and a Shabbos after. 6 days of creation in the middle. So if your kal v'chaymer is correct, that any time you have a bookmark, anytime you're surrounded by kedusha, there's a forbiddance from doing work. So every day of the week you should have an isra malacha. Shish kedusha lefneim l'achreim mutar masiyas malacha. Of course, that's not true. You could do work during the weekdays. So says the Gemara, Rav Yonasan, your kal v'chaymer is correct. Maybe not, asks the Gemara. Maybe the difference is that in regular weekday there's no karbanos, there's no karban musaf. Answers the Gemara. Rosh Chodesh yichichu. No, we see from Rosh Chodesh that even though on Rosh Chodesh yish bar karban musaf, there is a karban, and umotar masi is malacha, that it's mutar masi is malacha. And of course, we'll parenthetically point out that women have a kabbalah minog not to do harsh malachas, not to do laundry, etc. But it's one of those things that has to do with the malacha itself, and therefore they can put it in the laundry. The best is just to have a man press the button. But again, it's a minog, and the makom atzayrich there's what to be makel on that. But says the Gemara, that is Rosh Chodesh, Shishwe Karba Musaf, Umutar Ba'asiyas Malacha. Ask the Gemara further, Mal Rosh Chodesh Ein Kari Mikra Kodesh. Rosh Chodesh does not have the name of a yontif. It's not called a Mikra Kodesh, a coiling of holiness. Taimer B'chodesh HaMayish Kari Mikta Kodesh. Mikra Kodesh. So maybe you cannot equate Chol HaMoed with Rosh Chodesh. Ha'el v'kari Mikra Kodesh, since it's called Mikra Kodesh, Tenu Sh'asar Ba'asiyas Malacha. That's the reason why it's Asar Ba'asiyas Malacha, like the Kal V'chaymer of Rav Yonasan. So the Gemara is sticking to its guns. Rav Yonasan's Kal V'chaymer stance that what? That any day that there's a bookmark of Kedusha, there's going to be an Asar Ba'asiyas Malacha. And therefore says Rav Yonasan, you do not need a pasuk like Reish Lakish, like Rav Yechon wanted to suggest, a pasuk of showing us that there's 7 days of an Isser of Tishmar on Chag HaMatzah, showing us that there's an Isser Malacha on Chol HaMoed. Said Rav Yonasan, no, we can learn it from a simple Kal V'chaymer. The Gemara was bothered, why don't we ask from the Shishis Yimei Bereishis? Answers the Gemara, no, Karban Musaf. The Gemara was bothered by Rosh Chodesh as a Karban Musaf. Says the Gemara, no, fundamental difference. On Chol HaMoed, it's Mikra Kodesh. So a Mikra Kodesh with a bookmark of Kedusha, that's when there's an Isser Malacha, says Rav Yonasan, whereas Rosh Chodesh is no Isser Malacha, there's no bookmark, there's no Mikra Kodesh, excuse me, so there's no Isser Malacha on Rosh Chodesh. Tanya Idach, and therefore that's Rav Yonasan's way of learning. You do not need a pasuk like Rav Yechon and Reish Lakish, and rather you can learn the Isser Asiyas Malacha, you're not allowed to work a Chol HaMoed from a Kal V'chaymer. Tanya Idach, more Mikairais regarding the Isser to do work of Chol HaMoed. So far we had two. We had Rav Shlokish and Rav Yechon that said, Shivas Yamin by Pesach Tishmar, you have to watch 7 days showing us Isser Malacha. We had Rav Yonasan who learned it from a Kal V'chaymer, this bookmark of Kedusha with the Karba Musaf and their Mikra Kodesh. Tani Yidach, and now we have a third source. Kol Malach Zavoy Delo Sa'asu. It says in the Torah, you cannot do work for 7 days. And the pasuk continues. Well, let's pull up the pasuk over here. Many of you have on the side of your Gemara. Shiva Asiyamim Tekrivi Yishal Hashem B'Yom Hashemini Mekakodesh Yelachem Ekravdim Yishal Hashem B'Yisaris Yi Kol Melech Zavoy Deloy Zasu. The 7 days you cannot do Melacha. So from here says the Gemara, Li Mira Chol Shalmai this teaches us a Chol Amai Jasa Asi Yis Melacha Dev Rabbi Yisag Lili Yisag Lili Rabbi Kiva Oymer Eino Yitzarech Harei Oymer. Why do we not need the Pasuk says Rabbi Kiva? Because the Torah already taught us Ilam Moya De Hashem. These are the festivals of Hashem. B'Mah Kosam Medaber. What is the Pasuk referring to when it says, Eila, these are the Mayadim, these are the Yomim Tovim. In Berishain, if it's referring to the first day of Yontif, the first day of Sukkis, Harikvar Nemar, Shabbosan. It already called the first day of Sukkis Shabbosan. In Bishvi, Harikvar Shabbosan. Ha'ena, Kazim Edabir. So why did the Torah say, Eila, Mayadim, these are the Mayadim? The Pasuk is teaching, Ela, Bechoyloi Shalmayin. So the extra Pasuk says, Rabbi Akiva of Eila, Moyad Hashem teaches that Cholamoid has the status of a yontif lelamed chasha aser basiyas melacha is an iser to do work. So source number 3 of iser melacha that you cannot do work a Cholamoid is from ele moyad Hashem asher mikra yikodesh tani idach. And now we have a 4th source in the last narrow line sheishes yamim moving into the first wide line teichal matzo yisu bayom ashvi aser es Hashem 6 days yivim matzo and the 7th day is the yontif Hashem ashvi aser. Just like the 7th day is bound, it's forbidden from doing work. Says Gemara, 1 second. If the 7th day is restricted, it's yontif. If you can't do any work, are you going to tell me for all 7 days, even chol hamoed, you can't do any work? The 7th, hashvi'i atzurin, that's when you cannot do any work. But the previous 6 days, you could do work. So what yes and what no? The Torah gave it over to Chazal. And that's the entirety of, not the entirety, but that's much of the Sechz Maikatan, figuring out which one of those Malachas are the Malachas Asurais, which one of those Malachas are the Malachas Mutarais on Chol HaMoed. And that is the 4 sources of a forbiddance from doing work on Chol HaMoed. And now we continue 5 lines from the bottom, concluding this Mishnah that we learned, that mutarim be'asid u'betaynis, that it's mutter to have asid and taynis on this day, on the day that you shecht the carbon on Shavuos. Why? Sholikayim is divrei ayimim matzeres echa b'shabbos. That was a special din, that when the day of the shechita came out on a Sunday, that, and yontif was Shabbos, on that Sunday you allowed to have asid and taynis. Why? Particularly because we don't want the Sudukim used to say, it says Achara Shabbos, that Shavuos has to be on a Sunday. So in order to show that they're wrong, therefore we purposely say you're allowed to do a Sfeidim and Tainis on the day of the Shechita. So asks the Gemara, 4 lines Lebanon, Itmar of Altanya, Maisa Mesa Lachso Belud, there's a story that Lachso is Nifter in Lud, and they all came to do a speech. And Avdarif said, no. No, it's made them, it's yontif. Says Gemara, what's going on in this brisa? Yontif zal g'day doch. You really think it was proper yontif? Ibi yontif mikasi. If it was yontif, what does it mean? Then nechlesu kol Yisrael. How are they all coming? It's yontif. Elaim ha'am in neshi yontif u'achaya. Must have been the day of slaughter. Yontif was Shabbos. It was Sunday, the day of shechting the carbon. And yet we see that everyone came to say aspen. And what did Rav Tarvin say? No. Arguing on our Mishnah says you let have a speedim on the yontif u'ach. Answers the Gemara, loy kasha kam yontif shel chal yois achar Shabbos kam yontif shel chal yois b'Shabbos. In the case of Rav Tarfa, we're talking about when yontif fell out after Shabbos, and therefore we don't have this necessity, we don't have this burning desire to prove the Sedukim wrong, and therefore it's any other day of the week, and therefore we're not going to allow a Sfeidim. Whereas when it comes yontif is on Shabbos, then on that Sunday, excuse me, when yontif falls out on Shabbos itself, like we explained, that's the din of the Mishnah. And that's why has made the marmutter on Sunday. We turn over to Daf Yechesem Beis, and now we begin a completely new topic of Meseches Moikain, beginning the topic of Tuma Vitaira. And as we'll see, everyone gets very scared once you mention the word Tuma and Taira. But basically, for right now, all we need to know is that there are multiple levels of Tuma Vitaira, multiple levels within Kedusha. What are these multiple levels? As we list them, it will make it clearer. This chulin, which is on the, we'll call it the bottom, everything regular food, unconsecrated items. There's maaser sheni, something that you separated and you're going to go up in Yerushalayim. Then there's a truma, that which the kohen receives from, you know, a portion of the crops from the Yisraelim. Then there's something kodesh, which is like a karbon. And then the top level is mechatos. Mechatos is the waters of the ashes of the paraduma mixed together, in which you sprinkle it on someone and you're Shlish Yushvi, in order to be Mitairim. So we have five different levels of Taira, and the part, and the important part as we're going to see, is that that which is okay for one level is not okay for another level. So let's see the Mishnah. Says the Mishnah, Noitlin Aliyadayim, if you wash your hands, and of course washing your hands was Man Beis HaMikdash, was a much larger deal than it is unfortunately today, because they had to be careful with Tumah V'Tayra. So Noitlin Liyadayim, if you wash your hands, L'chulin, if you wash your hands either for a chulin, the bottom level, or Ula Ma'aser Sheni, or you wash it for the second level, Ula Truma, or you wash for the third level, then the halacha is, no, I read that incorrectly. Noitlin, not if, Noitlin Liyadayim, the chulin, the Ma'aser, the Truma. One has to wash his hands before dealing with either a chulin, Ma'aser, or Truma. Next in the Mishnah, Ula Kodesh. And when it comes to Kachim, level number four, you don't nightlin, you don't wash your hands, rather matbilin, rather you immerse your hands in a mikvah. And level five, the top level, or level one, Ula Chatos, and when it comes to using the Mechatos, the waters of the Eifer Baradum mixed with the water, im nitmu yadav nitma gufa. And when it comes to the mechatas, the halacha is the most chamer, that if your hands are tamei, your entire body is tamei, and you have to go to the mikvah. So again, on the first four levels, your hands are tamei, make your hands tar. How do you make your hands tar? For chulin, for maaser, for truma, just wash your hands. Next level, for kachim, you have to dip your hands in the mikvah. The top level for mechatas, if your hands are tamei, your body is tamei, and therefore your body has to go into the mikvah. Continues the Mishnah further, three lines down in Chesem Abis. Tava l'chulin, if someone went to the mikvah, now we're going to see that going to the mikvah again is also not as simple as just jumping into the water. One has to have kavana, one has to have a mindset for why he's going to the mikvah. There's five different levels, and pertinent to whichever level you're going to be dealing with, a Yisrael for chulin, a kain for kachim, or Chuma, then you need to have kavana for that level. So if someone went into the mikvah, taval lechulin, the halacha is hochzak lechulin. He's only tar for chulin, meaning, but he cannot deal with the next level, for example, meiser, chuma, etc. Aser lemeiser, like we just said, you can't deal with meiser. Tava lemeiser, ochzik lemeiser. If you went to the mikvah for a meiser, so now you're tar for meiser, but also lechuma, level 3. Tava lechuma, then ochzik lechuma, also lekoidish, level 4. Tava lekoidish, ochzik lekoidish, also lechatis, level 5. Tava lechamor, but now that we're at the top level, so once you go to the mikvah for level 5, for mechatis, then you could go all the way down, obviously. Mutter lekal, then you're allowed to go to a Then you're allowed to go to a lower level, and that goes in each level, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, etc. Tavol veloy hochzak. Let's say you went to the mikvah and you had no kavan at all. You didn't know. You just jumped into the water. You're going for a swim. You're going to take a bath. The halacha is ki'ilu loy tavol. It's as if you went to the mikvah, did not go to the mikvah at all. And now finally, the Mishnah discusses what is the status of clothing. The clothing of one that he is wearing, if he would be tamei, his clothing would be tamei. So says the Gemara, Big Day Ama Aretz, that if we have the clothing of an Ama Aretz, and Ama Aretz is always one who's assumed not to be careful with Tumah V'Tayra, so Midras Leprushim, it's considered Tumas Midras. Tumas Midras is tamei that you sit on. It's considered tamei for a Parush. A Parush is one who is separated. Parush is a Yisrael that only deals with Chulin, even Chulin B'Kedusha. So if an Ama Aretz sat on a towel, for example, then the Yisrael would not be able to use that towel when he wants to be eating chulin. Vegdei Purushin are mudras leichlei chuma. Again, now we're continuing up the totem pole. The big yadim of the chumas, of the Purushim, so they're careful about chula in the bottom level, but they're not careful about the next level, chuma. Vegdei leichlei chuma, the garments of those who eat chuma, the kehanim, are midras lekadshim, are considered tamei if someone wants to go eat a carbon. Vegdei kodesh, midras lechatas, the top level. And again, it's basically, we just keep on seeing that each of these levels is a higher and higher kedusha, and you have to know which level you're at with the kavana of that level. And the following, the Mishnah concludes that Yosef ben Yehezer, Yechasi Shabekahuna, Yosef ben Yehezer was the most devout, we'll call it, of all the Kehanim, Yosef Matpachasai, Midras Likadish. And yet, his napkin was Midras for someone who ate Kachim. For someone who ate Kachim, because he was a Kayin, Rashi explains over here, and therefore he was one that was careful with Chuma. However, for Zoni Kachim, not. We'll see Rashi in one moment. Let's just finish the Mishnah. Yechlam and Gudgida, Hayoichla Altairis, Akkadish, Koyamav, Yechlam and Gudgida was careful about Taira of everything's entire life, but yet, it would be a Midras for the Oichle Chatas, the top level. Let's see one Rashi before we go into the Gemara. Says Rashi at the end of the Mishnah, V'chol Eilu Mailois Midivrei Seifrim. These are all Dinei Derabbanan Sha'amru that the Chazal said, She'in Shmiras Ta'arosin Shal Eilu Chashuva Shmira Eitel Eilu. That guarding for this level doesn't work for the next level. U'midoy She'ein Eilu Eitel Eilu Ki'ilu Lo Shemrua. And therefore, it's as if you didn't watch the next level. Gazru Ben B'Gadim Shema Yashu Ben Ishtay Nida Vare Midras Anida V'chulu. And that is the reason why each level only works for that level, but not for the one at the next level. And the conclusion of the Mishnah is that even the greatest of everyone, still, it's only for the level that he is makbid on. Says the Mishnah, the first part of the Mishnah taught us a din of noitlin liyadayim, that you have to wash netilas yadayim for chulin maiser chuma. Says the Gemara, chulan umaiser mibay netilas yadayim. Levels 1 and 2, the bottom 2 levels, do they really need to wash their hands? Or a mini? We'll ask Kistira. Hachuma v'abikurin, if someone has chuma and bikurin, chayavin aleo alehen misa. Not koyhanim, if they get involved in chuma and bikurin, they're chayim misa v'chaymesh. And not only does a non-koyin who eats bikurin and chuma chayim misa, he also has to pay an extra fifth to the koyin. Why? Because you caused the koyin to get lost. And again, it's not going to be the same case. If you ate the chuma and the kachim bikurim intentionally, you're chayim misa. Not you, if someone. If you did it by accident, you're not chayim misa. So we have to give a chaymesh to the kohanim. Va'aser lezayirim, as we just explained, they're forbidden to not kohanim. Ve'nechzei kohanim, they consider the property of the kohen. Va'aylin bechel ne'umeya, and they would become bottled with 101. Uteunin netilas yedayim. That's of course what we're looking for. The Mishnah, this price about chuma and bikurim. Ni netilas yedayim. Ve'erev shemesh, and the setting of the sun. Hareelu chuma ubikurin. So it says that the price, let's be medayik. This is only by chuma and bikurin. Mashaykin me'maiser, which we see is not chuma and meiser. Ve'kol shekein bechulin. So says the Gemara, I don't understand. Our Mishnah taught us noitlin liyadayim for what? Chulin, meiser, and chuma. But we see in this price, the only time you have to be noiling your dime is for chuma and bikurim. Seemingly the next two levels on the bottom, maizur chulin, do not. Ask the Gemara, kasha maizur, maizur, kasha chulin, achulin. Explains the Gemara, bishlam, maizur, maizur, loy kasha, why not? Hara meir, hara banan. What is our meir? What's our banan? Titnan, as you learned in a Mishnah. Platon, bias, mayim, edivre, soifrim. Any entity that requires one to go into the mikvah, midirabana, meaning the midaraisa, it's tar. Midirabana, it becomes tameh, the mitam is a kodesh, and it becomes, and it makes a kodesh, it makes kachim tameh, ubaisal as a chuma and a baslam chuma, umudar. Lechulin ulamaisa diver a meir. And it's mutter for chulin and meiser. That's a meir. Let's continue and then we're going to explain. V'chachamim oisrim meiser. Say the chachamim, it's also for meiser. So what do we see? We see there's a difference between the chacham and a meir. So our Mishnah that says you have to wash your hands for meiser sheni is going to be of the Rabbanan. Whereas when the Gemara quoted a Mishnah in Bikurin, which said that you do not have to wash your hands, that's a pin of a meir. Fine. So we get answer. answer up simply as splitting up in the world of Meiser between Rav Meir and the Rabbanan. Ela chulin achulin gasha. How are we going to answer up this tira and chulin? In our Mishnah, it said you have to wash your hands for chulin. And in the Mishnah and Bikurin, as the Gemara just quoted, you do not have to wash your hands. Explains the Gemara, lo kasha kan ba'achila, kan benegia. In our Mishnah, we're talking about eating the chulin. That's when the Mishnah was being machmer to wash your hands. Whereas the Mishnah and Bikurin is talking about touching chulin. And therefore, you do not have to wash your hands. Maskevlar, Rav Simi Barashi, and this last detail that we just said, Ad kan lo pligi rabban alei de Rav Meir, when do the rabban argue on Rav Meir, ela ba'achila de ma'iser, eating ma'iser, not chulin, avu b'negia de ma'iser, o be'achila de chulin lo pligi. Everyone agrees. So how are you telling me that the difference between the Mishnah and the Mishnah and Bikurim is achila to negia? That's only by truma, but by the bottom level, by chulin, everyone agrees you do not have to be careful. Says the Gemara, you're right, and this will conclude. Ela idi vidi ba'achila, both our Mishnah and the Mishnah Bikurim are both talking about eating. V'loi kasha, kan ba'achila di nahamo, kan ba'achila di peri. What are you eating? Our Mishnah, we're talking about eating bread. Therefore, you have to wash your hands. The Mishnah in Bikurin is about eating fruits. Tamar Rav Nachman, kol hanoit el yodav laperis, arizem megasei ruach. So the achila, it comes out, a very interesting din, that when we're talking about the washing the hands in our Mishnah, is talking about a different type of netilas yadayim. It's talking about a netilas yadayim of a bread. Whereas the Mishnah Bikurin that says you do not have to wash your hands, that's talking about the netilas yadayim for fruit, in which one is considered gasi ruach, one is considered a hori if he does such. And that's the reason why the Mishnah there says you do not have to wash your hands for bread. We'll pick it up from Dana Rabbanan in the next year.